Greetings. Thank you, Brother Jack, for your posts. Let's look at your first post and then I will address it point by point. What do you mean? Show me the Quran verse. Are there any Trinity word in that verse? When Trinity existed? After 100 years Jesus' departure or before? Are you sure in that verse Jesus claimed Mary as God too? That verse is one of the miracles in Quran. If you claimed Jesus is God, so what could Mary be? Mother of God? Your God have mother and father? Is it possible Mary is God too? You answer it. Use your brain while answer it. That's why the verse is in the Quran, not in your Bible. The question of the Trinity in the Quran is an interesting topic, brother. Without question, the author of the Quran attempts to directly challenge this truth of God. Let's go through your post point by point. What do you mean? Show me the Quran verse. Are there any Trinity word in that verse? So, brother, your first point is to make a demand where the word Trinity exists in the Quran. And there are really three logical approaches to answer this, brother. The first is that Trinity is an English word and thus could never appear in an Arabic Quran. That is because Muhammad did not speak English, right? The second is that it does not matter whether the English word Trinity appears or not. The word Trinity does not have to appear because the concept clearly appears. The concept is so clear that translators clarify the Quran. Surah 573, the Assad translation. Indeed, the truth deny they who say, behold, God is the third of a Trinity. The Yusuf Ali. They do blaspheme who say Allah is one of three in a Trinity. The Al-Muntakab. Again, infidels indeed are those who say Allah in Trinity. The monotheist group. Rejectors indeed are those who have said God is a Trinity. The Ahmed Ali. Disbelievers are they, surely, who say God is the third of the Trinity. That is five translators, brother, scholars in Arabic. And they are so certain they do not add brackets to indicate additions. So there is no question, brother. Surah 573 is talking about the Christian teaching of the Trinity. The third logical path is that the argument you make is simply logically fallacious, or a false logic. If your argument is that Trinity is never addressed because the word Trinity is never used, then, brother, to be logically honest, you must consistently use that argument. The Arabic word, Tawheed, which describes Allah's one and only oneness, does not appear in the Quran. What do you mean? Show me the Quran verse. Are there any Trinity word in that verse? Brother, your first point is no point at all. Surah 5, 73 through 75, tries to argue against the Trinity. When Trinity existed, after 100 years Jesus' departure, or before? Brother, the concept of the Trinity of God was revealed by the Comforter. This was one teaching Jesus could not say before he was crucified. John 16:12, I have yet many things to say unto you, but you cannot bear them now. Howbeit, when he, the Spirit of truth, is come, he will guide you into all truth, for he shall not speak of himself. The Trinity is the truth of God, too deep for even the disciples to bear before the Comforter came. But whatsoever he shall hear, that shall he speak, and he will show you things to come. The Comforter has heard God speak of the Trinity, and has revealed the Trinity after Jesus was crucified. Now that the Comforter, the Holy Spirit, has clarified the Trinity, it is easy to see the Trinity all through the Old Testament. The Holy Spirit has given eyes to see to those with hearts honestly seeking God. Brother, you should ask God to give you eyes to see. If your heart honestly desires to know the truth of God, pray and ask the God of Abraham to guide you. Pray and ask the God of the prophets to guide you. Ask the God of the prophets to reveal His name to you. Are you sure in that verse Jesus claimed Mary as God too? Brother, in your first post, you did not mention specific surahs. You did attempt to mention and list a few in a subsequent post. Let's honestly look at the several ayat which address the Trinity. Surah 5, 73 through 75 definitely attempts to argue against the Trinity, but this is Muhammad speaking, not Jesus. We'll come back to this in a moment. Surah 5, 116 attempts to put words in Jesus' mouth, and it mentions Mary as God. Let's examine 5:116 because that is the ayat which puts words in Jesus' mouth. Surah 5:116, "And behold, Allah will say, O Jesus, the son of Mary, didst you say unto men, worship me and my mother as gods in derogation of Allah? He will say, glory to thee, never could I say what I had no right to say. And behold, Allah will say, O Jesus, the son of Mary." This ayat represents to be Allah speaking to Jesus. The time is unspecified in this ayat, but it must take place after the allegation, after the alleged topic Allah is about to ask about. Now, I do not want to diverge or distract, but I thought perhaps the context would establish the time. So I looked back at 5:115 and found no mention of when. And I looked back at 5:114 and found no mention of when. But 5:114 did say something which caught my eye. Issa the son of Maryam said, O Allah our Lord, send down to us food from heaven which should be to us an ever-recurring happiness, to the first of us and to the last of us, and a sign from thee, and grant us means of sustenance, and thou art the best of the providers. A statement, a prayer, which Allah answers in 5:115. Allah said, I will send it down unto you. But if any of you after that resists faith, I will punish him with a penalty such as I have not inflicted on anyone among all the peoples. When? I was looking for when the imaginary conversation of 5:116 happened. Now, I'm wondering when this imaginary promised banquet from Allah happened. But let us not get distracted, brother, from the logical meaning of 5:116. Didst thou say unto men, did you say unto men, worship me and my mother as gods? Did you, Jesus, tell men to worship you and Mary as gods? The question is based on a presumption, brother, that men worshipped Jesus and Mary as gods. If men were not worshipping Jesus and Mary as gods, the question is nonsense. It makes just as much sense for Allah to ask, Jesus, did you tell men that I, Allah, am an eight-breasted cow? It is irrational to ask stupid crap questions if they pertain to nothing. So if Allah is asking about Mary and Jesus worshipped as gods, that question came from somewhere. Allah clearly thinks someone is worshipping Jesus and Mary as gods with Allah. Now please, count along with me, brother. Allah. 1. Jesus? 2. Mary? 17. 4. 3. The author of the Quran thinks the Trinity means three gods of Allah, Jesus, and Mary. There is no other more reasonable reading or meaning, brother. Unfortunately for the author of the Quran, it demonstrates ignorance or stupidity, brother. If the author is Muhammad alone, it makes perfect sense that an unlearned man who cannot read nor write would know nothing of Christian scriptures and teachings. But this demonstrated ignorance utterly refutes and disproves the claim the author is all-knowing. If Allah is the author, he is not all-knowing. If you claimed Jesus is God, so what could Mary be, mother of God? Your God have mother and father? Brother, the message of the prophets reveals Yahweh would come to earth. Brother, the message of prophets Isaiah, Malachi, and John proved Jesus is Yahweh in the flesh come to earth. I just believe the prophets, and I repeat their message to you. If you do not believe the prophets, then you are a disbeliever, an infidel, brother. It is the scheme of Al-Makr, the best deceiver, to trick you into thinking you believe the prophets, even as you reject their message for the word of one man alone. If you claimed Jesus is God, so what could Mary be, mother of God? Your God have mother and father? Brother, the prophets say nothing of Mary except that the virgin shall conceive a son. Some Christian sects wrongly elevate Mary above other women, and even wrongly pray to her. That is clearly a sin and a teaching not taught by the prophets of God. Is it possible Mary is God too? You answer it. Use your brain while answer it. Brother, as I have just said, Mary is not God, and there is no scripture in the Torah or Bible which hints she is. And there is no reason for Allah or the author of the Quran to incorrectly think or argue that there is. But the fact the Quran wrongly defines the Trinity as God the Father, Jesus, and Mary proves the author's ignorance. It proves the Quran comes from an author who is not all-knowing, all-wise. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.